Well, hello, motherfuckers. Well, we've already been demonetized, so if you ever wanted to say something that's really messed up, you could do so right now.
All right, let me think of it. Hold on. I hate the...
Oh, man. Thank God I learned that bleeping trick. We're in the TD Garden.
Are we?
Yeah, it's in Boston.
God.
Hopefully
God help us.
Hopefully the racists don't show up.
Yeah, hopefully.
Welcome to Boston. They're all racists.
Welcome. That's the slogan, isn't it?
Welcome to Boston. We're all racist. I believe so, yeah.
Could that be the title of this video?
I think it's too long.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
I could title it, I'm not racist.
I'm not racist. I like it. I like it.
I could title it, yeah, I'm not racist, Joyner Lucas. See if we could confuse anybody. And they're like, what happened? Where did my song go?
Someone's looking for the fucking music video.
That was my favorite thing to do with Putty Save or whatever. We got so many clicks on Mania because people thought we somehow, like, knew into the fucking future and were able to, like, like, there were people who commented, like, this isn't WrestleMania 34. This is a game. I'm like...
That's fucking go.
We were, like, 2 years off at the time. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Anyways, you ready to rock and roll?
I'm as ready as I'm going to be.
We've got a big return tonight.
Yeah, we do.
It's the return of Ernest Miller.
That's true.
Let's go to it.
Let's do it.
We open things up with an ADB. We see Chris Benoit, and he's hanging out in the back, being weird.
Oh, poor choice of words. Poor choice of words.
He's hanging... We're done. Episode
That's
over.
It.
Good shit.
That's it, guys.
So,
good job.
So he's hanging out in the back, and, you know, Eddie's, like, slumped over in the corner.
Poor choice of words again.
Rey Mysterio walks in, and he's like, yo, I think I just broke somebody's neck. What the fuck?
Jesus. Fuck's sake.
It's like the murderer corner over here. The murderer corner plus Eddie Guerrero.
Oh my god.
That's okay, though.
I forgot that dude died off the fucking...
That's okay, though, because Eddie can fit in with this group, because 370, Eddie's not up here. He's down there.
Oh, no.
Anyways, so Chris Benoit's like, hey, Eddie, we were friends. Are we still friends? And Eddie's like, I get, okay. I'm okay with this.
Good show.
Eddie Guerrero's just like, assessment. Affirmative.
Jesus. He's a robot.
And so Chris Benoit's like, yeah, that's great, Eddie. So how you been doing? And Eddie Guerrero's like, assessment. Not positive. And Chris is like, oh man, what's been going on with you, Eddie? Oh, hey, Ray. And Ray walks in and he's like, everybody know how to hide a body. And they're like, what? And then Guerrero's like, assessment. Negative. Chris Benoit's like, Chris Benoit's like, I have a few ideas. I've got a pool area. Just don't leave the dogs in there.
Good God. This
fucking ankle. I'm just...
I don't know if I can,
gun them all down real quick.
Good Lord.
Gun them all down. Thank God we don't have any shooters in this angle. Wow. Jay White will not debut for a few more years. I'm sorry, no, he's the knife pedophile. Not to be confused with Marty Scurll, the actual pedophile.
The shoot pedophile. Not to be confused with 370 Gaming, the work pedophile.
The TEW work pedophile. You know, everybody's got their work pedophile. They go into work first thing in the morning, and they're like, oh, yeah, there's Steve over there, the work pedophile. And he's like, hello, did you bring your child today? And it's like, no, Steve, go away.
Jesus.
Yeah, poke him with a stick.
What is this episode? This is horrible.
I feel like that was either the funniest opening to an episode ever, or super terrible. This video has 20 dislikes. Anyways. So, you know, Ray explains that, like, oh, man, we're having trouble with these Canadian people. Fucking Canadian people. And Chris Benoit's like, aight. Mexican. I was going to say something else there, but I... I showed restraint. I was gonna call him a little itty bitty chihuahua. Shout out to Alberto L. Racist. Alberto L. Wifebeat. he fucking took member of Cult of Benoit, Alberto L. Patron.
How many more gimmicks can we get in here?
1,000, brother. I'm on fire tonight.
Man, let's go.
Just like it. Jeff Hardy's house.
Oh.
I killed your dog, Jeff.
Wow.
Killed your fucking dog.
Just like in the pool the Undertaker's area. Parents.
I will set your dog on fire.
Oh my god, let's go.
Anyways, Chris Benoit.
Oh my
like,
god, I just had a nice. Hold on, I just had a tag ahead, angle shoot, for next shoot. Week.
Tell me off screen.
I'll tell you off screen.
Anyways, basically, Chris Benoit is like, yeah, guys, I'll help you out with that. You know, I know how to handle the Canadian people. I'm pretty good with the Canadian people. I was a Canadian person myself before I killed myself after murdering my wife and child. I can take care of that Edge guy. You know, I can take care of him. You'll never see him again.
The cleaner, Chris Benoit.
The fucking cleaner. Didn't do a very good job, did he?
Fuck's sake. No, he didn't.
He didn't. He really fucked up.
Good God.
By he, of course, I mean Kevin Sullivan. You murdered Chris Benoit.
That's my favorite theory.
You damn bastard.
Fucking killed him.
If Kevin Sullivan will work for us, he's coming in and trying to kill Chris Benoit.
Oh, every week.
Every week.
Every week.
It's the fucking,
Tim White.
Yes, Tim. I was going to say Dan White, but it's like here we are with Mr. Sullivan. Mr. Sullivan, that's not wise, Mr. Sullivan.
That's not wise, Mr. Sullivan. He always gets like blown back like fucking Acme cartoon style. Yeah.
It's like if I put the piranhas in Chris Benoit's bathtub, he'll die in his sleep when he's in the tub. And it's like, oh fuck, that was my tub. Anyways, so Chris Benoit is going to take on Edge in the main event.
Good God. What an opening.
There's 7.5 minutes on the first angle.
Great.
We move into a 66C+ as the return of the cat. Jerry Lynn beats him in about 5 minutes with a cradle.
I'd like to make a note where I pushed for the cat to have promo time and was denied.
It'll happen on Raw.
No,
just
it
like
won't.
All those other things that'll happen on Raw. Like Ronda Rousey.
Too soon? Yeah. You don't remember?
No, Fabulous Moolah was the one who whored out the... Never mind. I was like, wait, did she do that? Oh, no, that was Moolah.
I think Ronda did that in the UFC.
Fuck. Literally. Jerry Lynn gets an in-ring performance of 68.
Oh.
He's the fucking
one
man.
Off. Just one off.
Ernest Miller gets 46.
Yes.
He went out there and he did that thing.
He's a god, bro.
He's
push him.
I don't know if I'd call him that. Ernest Miller got a bonus
title tomorrow,
for charisma.
But... Yes.
Jerry Lynn did not get a bonus for charisma.
No shit.
Jerry Lynn's
fantastic.
Ernest Miller's like, yeah. And Jerry Lynn's like,
no.
Yes.
Ernest Miller's like, meow!
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 And Jerry Lynn's like,
meow.
Meow. That was a real mood killer. All right, let's move on.
Yeah. Yep.
74B-. We're with Stacy Keibler, and she's in Dudleyville. She's on her throne in Dudleyville. With Bubba Ray, D-Von, and like Spike somewhere, but we don't really see him because I forgot he's kind of part of this Dudleyville gimmick. Anyways, and she makes it official. Dudleyville has declared war on the United States of America. May the bombs begin to drop.
That's crazy.
Yeah, I don't have much else to say about that. Oh, she's also like, yeah, on Monday, Taker, D-Von.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
That's a good one. She also insists that she was not kidnapped.
Yeah, she's like, I am here willingly, and like stares in the camera, like blinks three times. and so we get
shoot,
this
breaking news, ladies and gentlemen.
What's going on?
Stephen Hawking has died.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh fuck! No, seriously.
Yeah, Stephen Hawking died at 76.
Hold on, I gotta go on Twitter to confirm.
It's a shoot, brother. I actually saw this like 30 minutes ago, and it was like one source, and I was like, yeah, nah. But now it's like it's actually a thing.
Hold on, I don't know the fuck you spelled Stephen Hawking.
You don't?
No, is it Stephen Hawking?
Yes.
I'm a basketball guy, so.
I know. Yeah, I know.
Fucking rip.
Yep.
Wow.
Yep. Can we make this title of this video? Stephen Hawking has died. Is that really insensitive?
That's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
Wow, man. Fuck. I think Elon killed him.
I think so.
He was like, I need your power to power my rockets.
I need your power.
I will set Stephen Hawking on fire. Kane fucking killed him.
Right here is where we lose subscribers. This is the moment.
Kane fucking killed him.
Kane killed him.
Mayoral candidate Glenn Jacobs murdered Stephen Hawking.
Fuck's sake.
Anyways, Dudleyville declares war. Moving forward.
How are you going to set anybody on
get
fire?
Get the fuck out of here, it's Lita.
You're posting pics of your wife on Instagram. What?
It's Lita. Get the fuck out of here.
Oh, shit. My bad.
So Matt and Jeff Hardy, they cut a promo on William Regal. And, you know, they said, "Ah, William, you tried to break my brother Jeff's leg. I don't stand for that. I am Matt Hardy before the broken gimmick. So I speak like this. It's really weird. I am Matthew Hardy, and I will beat you," and the words escaping me, it rhyme. I don't even know at this point. Okay, I'm gonna break you, and then Lita's gonna break your penis. So watch out. Welcome back, 370 Gaming. Hooray!
Boo. Hey, who the hell was that? Boo! Hey, shut up, bitch! Hey, fuck you! Whoa! Wait a minute now.
Who's that?
Who's that? Wait, who is this? Kill yourself, you fucking cunt! Oh, Jesus!
Oh,
wow.
Oh my God!
This is really heat. Who's in the audience?
Are you booing? Are you booing? Are you saying boo 70?
Boo 70. That's
I was saying boo 70.
Jesus. Gimmick dad. All right, go ahead.
It's a fucking 5 sausage roast.
What?
It's 5 men and a hardcore belt.
Oh.
And
that's hot.
Yeah, and so Norman Smiley. Okay, so it's a fatal 4-way between Rob Van Dam, Billy Gunn, Albert, and Test. And Norman Smiley just walks onto the fucking scene, and we're like, I guess you're here now.
Pretty much.
It's backstage. It's fucking chaos for like 9 minutes. And then Billy Gunn just hits Norman Smiley with a fucking Famouser and wins the hardcore belt and leaves.
Lit.
Rob Van Dam's like, I didn't even get pinned. How does this rule even work anymore? Like, this makes no sense. Shouldn't I have to get pinned? Because there's no fucking matches? but no, Rob Van Dam loses the belt. Billy Gunn is hardcore champion. Fucking rip. Yeah, all right, moving forward. It's a 71 C plus.
Sweet.
76 B minus as Scott Steiner cuts a promo on Raven. He says, "We understand here that the king of the ring is not a circle, it's a square. And you see the square has 4 sides, but there's only 2 sides. when I take on Raven on Monday, there'll be two sides, but it's only gonna be one side because Raven cannot have a piece of ring because he's a bird, and birds do not land very much. They do with some little electricity poles, but those poles, they got electricity, and they're for me because I'm Scott Stein. I'm electrifying Scott Stein, not Dwayne Johnson. Where is Dwayne Johnson? Dwayne Johnson do a movie. He doesn't come here anymore. I do the movie. My muscle, look at my muscle do movie. I flex a lot. Ha! And Raven can't beat me because Raven is a bird, and I've said it before, and I say again, I have killed birds before.
Jesus.
Here comes the money.
I have killed birds before.
And money just starts to rain down on the Scott Steiners. Everybody in the crowd's like, I will pay for the killed a bird before t-shirt.
That was a Your Steiner promos are spot on.
It's just, I just go with whatever the fuck I can think of, and like anything that like in my head says, hey, that doesn't relate at all, I'm like, connect them now.
Connect them right away.
I have like an A and a B, and very quickly in my mind, I'm like, what's the dumbest way I can connect them? I'm like, okay, I'm like, bird, not ring, land, pole, electricity, rock, muscle, movie, muscle, kill, bird, Raven.
Go. Perfect.
By the way, that's my slam poetry. You can pick it up now. And yeah, it's an alright promo. Moving forward.
Yeah.
We get a 79B. Wow.
Oh.
As Chris Jericho beats the Big Show. And here's your updated look at the King of the Ring bracket here. I mean, I guess it's not totally updated because this isn't on there yet. So Big Show's X'd out. But on Monday, we're going to see Scott Steiner take on Raven. And as we've heard from Scott Steiner, he has killed birds before. So
literally,
what does that mean? Nobody really fucking knows, actually. So your guess is as good as ours.
I have another gimmick to pitch to you.
Yes. Anyways, Big Show got a bonus for charisma. Sure.
Hey.
No, I'd say that's about right, actually. Big Show's a very charismatic guy. I mean, he hasn't gotten this far into the fucking business by being, I'm a giant.
I mean, his shoot has charisma.
He does.
Never use it, like, correctly.
It's like, except for that, like, one time. I was going to say, just like Mark Henry, except for, like, those two times where they used it properly, and it was, like, the greatest fucking thing ever.
Literally.
Mark Henry's a god. True. Let's move forward, shall we?
Yes,
it's a 58C- as we go backstage. It's Ivory and Steven Richards, and they're with Bull Buchanan. Do you want to explain this
let's
angle?
Let's go. I mean, you booked it, to be fair?
I did, but so I wanted to get you involved more, you know what I mean? Like,
I can't see the screen,
it was
so
your make-a-wish to be on an episode with me. So, you know, I'm just trying to do my part here.
Before I die from AIDS and...
From AIDS?
You popped too early. I couldn't think of a second gimmick.
I think AIDS wins the day.
AIDS wins... Well, yeah,
there's
but I was
your gonna... title. AIDS wins the day.
AIDS wins the day. Fantastic. Well, I was gonna give myself a lesser problem to be, like, funny. I was gonna be like, AIDS and this hangnail I've got.
That thing that Stephen Hawking had.
Oh.
Had. That's so weird. I can now say had for that.
Wow.
Moment of silence, everyone.
What did Stephen Hawking...
Okay, we're done. We're done here. All right, so anyways, Ivory and Stephen Richards, they're like, China, you're gonna fight Bull Buchanan, but not a fight. Oh, I'm sorry, I'm still in Scott Steiner mode, so I'm kind of stammering and stuttery. You're gonna face Bull Buchanan in a weightlifting contest.
It's fucking goat.
And that's on Monday.
ALS.
Everybody has ALS.
Yeah?
I mean, like, there was a baseball player, right?
Do you have ALS?
I don't.
Oh.
Do you have ALS?
No, I have AIDS.
Oh.
Yeah.
I didn't know you were gay. Is that...
I said I was gay.
Is that too controversial of a joke? Can people touch that with a 10-foot pole? Or
let's see.
The 100-foot one?
We've touched Benoit, Eddie.
I would say that's worse than anything I've said thus far. Maybe it's just a personal thing.
AIDS joke?
Yeah, even then. But then again, I guess it's out of, like, you know what I mean? It's, like, just known as a joke now, you know what I mean? The, like...
What? What's known as a joke?
Like, the people at one point were like, oh, man, you can only get AIDS if you're gay.
Right.
So, like, right. I think people now know it's just a fucking, like, meme, right? So, like...
That's a good point.
I don't know. Whatever. Let's move forward.
Yep. Moving forward.
98A Star.
Go.
Triple H is talking to Steve Austin, and he says, Steve, listen to me, all right? I know you're having a good time there. You're world champion or whatever. You're whatever the hell you've been calling Dwayne. You know, you're... what the hell have you been calling him? Austin's like, the antithesis of Steve Austin. It's like, yeah, so him. I know he's been gone. He's been hurt or whatever, but, like, he was doing movies. I don't know, man. I talked to that Scott Steiner guy. He seems kind of weird. I don't like him. I have bigger muscles than him, I think. Maybe that'll be an angle down the road. But, like, you know, I need you to, like, do some shit, you know? Like, I don't know, man. Like, you've just kind of been hanging out. You've been drinking a lot. Like, Deborah's starting to get concerned. And, like, when Deborah's concerned for your health, you know there's a problem. Because, like, you've almost killed her, like, 3 times now, man. Like, you've got a problem, Steve. And Steve's like, Steve, I ain't got no fucking problem. I'm fucking Steve Austin. I do what the fuck I want. I fucking drink as much as I want. And Trips is like, I understand, Steve. But, like, those two guys, right? Booker and DDP, you know, they've kind of got me on the ropes here, because, like, I hate to say this and say this to you, you know, because I think we've you know, grown together a little bit in the past, like, fucking, what, 2 months. But, like, you know, you haven't been really helping much lately, you know? Like you're pretty good when you go, but, like, You don't go often, you know? Steve's like, fuck you mean, boy! You know, fuck it, you know what? I'd kick your ass right now, but hey, you know what? You've got money, I've got money, right? We're on the same page. Here, Deborah, fuck this shit. And, yeah, we just go off air with Steve Austin starting to beat Deborah.
I like it.
There you go. Let's move forward.
I can really relate to Steve Austin.
Holy fuck, it's Goldust!
Oh!
Goldust weirdo gimmick got an average rating.
Cool.
Goldust has a match against Rikishi. It's a storytelling match, and the story... Would you like to explain the story, 370?
The story is that Goldust is back. But that's not all.
No, Goldust likes to touch Rikishi's... would you like to do the honors?
What does he like to touch, Tuck? You gotta
no, that's you. That's you.
No, you do it.
This is weird for me. I'm underage. You can't make me say this.
I... do, because I am a pedophile, so you have
oh
to
damn
yep
true
yep
fuck
how much you know what is am I gonna is like an employer gonna go through one of these videos
yeah, they'll be like nope like, they'll be like that right there nope
they'll see that right and they'll hear literally I am a pedophile 370 gaming and they're gonna be like nope. Yeah, or like can you imagine
370's legal name is 370 gaming. They'll be like, let me look at my new employee here, 370 Gaming. What's he done in the past? Oh. He's a pedophile.
He's a pedophile, huh?
Anyways.
Oh, I just imagine, right? Like, I've blown up. Like, I'm like, you know, like I have, you know, what, 2,000 subscribers? 5 years from now.
Ooh.
And, I get like, PewDiePie'd in an expose by the fucking Wall Street Journal or some shit, you know? They find this video, and they you know, he's a pedophile. It's
370
like,
Gaming is secretly a Nazi.
Ooh. Not secretly.
Not secretly. Oh, man.
Oh. Maybe I'll expose myself.
That sounds like quality content.
Both literally and figuratively.
I'm just telling you right now, I think your best content is when you do the shitty, like, new content gimmicks or whatever.
Yeah.
I think that's the best stuff. I think the general consensus is that that's the best stuff.
Oh, I think so. I think when I do weird shit that's, like, not a series, like, Where Is 370 and, like, shit like that.
Well, Where Is 370 got fucking heat. People were like, no, boo.
Did that get heat?
That did. You had to stop it early, remember? You had, like, other parts planned out, but you had to wrap it up because people were, like, starting to fucking get pissed.
That's true. Because
nobody
right.
can handle a fucking angle.
Welcome to TEW
community where people can't handle jokes or angles.
Man, they're gonna be really pissed when I drop my new fucking rap single in like a couple weeks from this video.
That's true. They're gonna be really pissed at me when they're like, "Hey, you were specifically talking about me when you made that general statement." Welcome
literally.
To fucking TEW, where everybody's ego is bigger than their subscriber count, which realistically isn't that big. Anyways, Goldust just fucking grabs Rikishi's tits the entire time.
Yeah.
His man tits. He just fucking rubs them down, rubs them up, you know, and they're like, "Hey, Goldust, he's gay. That's funny and weird. Ha ha, gay people."
ha!
Ha! And that's the gimmick. Let's move forward. Holy shit.
What's up?
98 A-Star from Booker and DDP.
Let's go.
So they've got like a shitty, they're like backstage like that, and they're just like doused in like light in like a dark room, and they're just talking about how, like, you know, they've got Triple H on the run, they've got Steve Austin on the run, sooner or later they're gonna have the belts, the money, the bitches, the fame, the gold, the chains, the rings, the dames, the dimes, the planes, the chicks, the
yep
can't think of another thing, bars. And obviously it's Booker T who says that, as that is an African-American thing.
Do you remember when you did the freestyle to Panda?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm okay at that. I'm okay at rapping, I would say.
Yeah.
I would say I'm a solid... I'm like not like... Like, I don't know. I'm not Kendrick level, but I'm like Eminem level, you know what I mean? I'm like...
Yeah.
Really good, but like I'm kind of out of my prime now, because like people keep harassing me to like do songs with Beyonce, and I'm like, "Beyonce, go away." And then Jay-Z's like, "What the fuck you say about my wife, sucker?" And I'm like, "Okay, I'll do a song with her, whatever."
Sucker. He's Booker T.
He's Booker T. Let's move forward. Right. Chris Benoit walks the ring for the main event. Main event itself gets a 79B.
Okay.
So, Edge beats Chris Benoit by countout. Do you care to explain why this is 370?
Because, you see, you know, the last time we saw it, there was a restraining order that Lita has against me.
Yes.
There was a separate restraining order.
Yes.
This restraining order was Kurt Angle to Chris Benoit.
Yes.
And, unfortunately for Chris Benoit, Kurt Angle happened to come out to the ring.
Remember, Kurt Angle is boys with Edge and Christian, right?
He is. They're boys. He is boys. They are boys. Not boys like OSW boys, but they are like shoot boys.
Shoot boys. They are the all-night crew of SmackDown and Raw.
Too soon. That was the last
too,
controversial
too
dead
soon
joke.
As if that ever happened? Like...
This might be my favorite episode of the series.
Can you too soon something that didn't happen? That's like being like, that's like me saying like, "Oh man, like, how about like Chris Benoit in heaven?" And you're like, "Oh, too soon." Like, it's like, didn't happen, bruh.
Damn.
I couldn't really find like any, like, you know what I mean? Like a situation where I was like, "Oh, you know," you'd be like, be like you saying like, "Oh yeah, like Tuck sexual experience," and I'm like, "Too soon." Like, I can't say that because it never happened.
Damn.
Fucking rip myself damn. Right quick, hey, right?
Seven out.
There you go. It took me a lot of, you know, that took a lot out of me, because as I said, I'm part of the TEW community where everybody's ego is fucking ginormous. I love everyone in the TEW community, and all of them are really great people. I just am
big
joking
ups
around.
Big ups to big fan.
Big fan of you, buddy. Shower me in those dislikes and I'll fucking, I don't know, I'd say something, but I've already pissed off enough people. My favorite ongoing gimmick about my channel is how I don't give a fuck in this series. I just say whatever I feel like.
Literally.
Like, you watch my ECW thing for, I think, like, some resemblance of quality content, and then this is just me, being super cancer, and you feed into it. You know what I mean? Like,
I do. Big
Putty,
time.
Putty
big
would
time.
Quell it. He'd be like, "You can't say that. What the fuck?" And then,
yeah,
you know, you laugh at it, so it encourages me. You're an enabler.
Oh yeah, and then I partake.
Yeah, you're an enabler.
I'm an enabler.
You're a neighbor.
I'm a I'm your friendly neighborhood.
Your friendly neighborhood workplace pedophile. Get out of here, Steve.
Oh, excuse me. Tuck, answer the door.
Oh, hello. Who's that?
Oh, hello. I am 370 Gaming. I'm required to let you know that I am a pedophile. I've just moved in to
all right,
the DW all community.
Right, let's end this fucking episode. It's an 83B plus as, you know, Chris Benoit's like, man, I can't go into that ring and beat up Kurt Angle. And then Ray and Eddie come out and they're like, it's okay, SA, we'll do it for you. So they go down there and they start beating up Edge and Kurt Angle. There's
yeah,
a brawl.
Big schmoz.
Yeah, and then Christian tries to go down there, you know, and give his boys the edge. But then Benoit cuts him off, locks him in the crossface, and the faces, nice. they have a happy time.
Happy time.
And the show overall gets an 86B plus, up an 8.
All right.
That's pretty solid, I like to think.
That's good. The booking for this episode came out a lot better than I had anticipated coming in.
Well, I don't know. I had some ideas. Like, I had specifically the women idea I had an okay idea for with Bull Buchanan. I kind of knew
I wanted
some things to go, but, like, not really. You know what I mean?
Yeah. And then when I pitched the gimmick with getting the two gimmicks together for the main event,
yeah, that
I'm just saying.
Really well.
Yeah, that worked out like better than I thought. Mm-hmm. So that was pretty cool.
Well, good shit, everyone. I hope I haven't offended you enough for you to unsubscribe to this channel, because I need those subs actually, because you know my ego, it's not as big as like I don't know 370 Gaming's. Oh,
guys, do you want to tell them the real reason why you need your subscribers?
Why do I need my subscribers? Do I know this gimmick? I'm trying to think. I'm like, why do I need them?
The real reason is because you have AIDS and you're going to die soon. And
my make-a-wish is for you to stop.
Your make-a-wish going. Is to have 500,000 subscribers.
Jesus Christ. We're aiming a little low, aren't we?
Keemstar. Yeah, you're right. My bad.
We gotta hit that where's, 1 mil.
Where's Keemstar, brother?
Where
everyone tweet at Keemstar. What's his at? What's his at Keemstar?
I don't know. I'm going to cut you off before you can figure it out.
It's at Keemstar.
Oh, fuck. How do we end this episode now?
Go tweet at Keemstar. Tuck is a...